problem you have today, you had when you met, but you were fucking, so you forgave.
Just got married. Just got married again. This is my second marriage. This one gotta work. I fucked that first marriage up. I fucked it up. This one gotta work. You know how much alimony and child support that'd be? I would have to get hit by a second Walmart truck. And a Doritos truck. And a FedEx plane. Heard you can make a quiet $20 million off a FedEx plane if you survive with all your faculties and limbs and shit. That'd be messed up if you was just a torso on the head. Your friend carry you around in a Gucci bag on his back. Yo, take me to the beach, man. Put me where the bitches be. If it get too hot, I'ma go, ooh, that mean come get me. You just a torso with a chinchilla on.
You wanna stay together. How do you stay together? You gotta fuck. It's that simple. You got to fuck. People always say, oh, when we got together, it was so much fun, but then problems arose. No, they didn't. Nothing arose. Every problem you have today, you had when you met, but you were fucking, so you forgave. Right. You knew he didn't do dishes. But he gave you good dick. That was a swell trade, dick for dishes. You used to love washing them dick dishes. So you knew she couldn't cook, but she licked your balls. You're like, ah, keep licking, we'll order in. You got to fuck. You gotta fuck, you gotta keep it up. And you gotta fuck no matter what mood you in. You got to keep this shit moving. You can't wait for the Holy Ghost to just get you. That's right. That's right, ladies, are you listening to me? And sometimes you gotta suck a melancholy dick. You gotta do what you gotta do. Cause I could eat pussy in a horrible mood. I can't believe there's no gas in the car. Can't believe there's so much mold in the basement. Shit, I eat pussy on 9/11. Where were you?
If you single, you should be fucking every chance you get. Just in case, you never know. And if you in a relationship, do more fucking. And women, I'm not talking to y'all. I know y'all are always ready, ready, ready. Talking to men, we only want to give her perfect dick. No, give her all the dicks. Give her happy dick, sad dick, angry dick. She loves angry dick. I don't know what done got in them. But this is finally what I've been talking about right here. This is exactly.
Yeah, I'm just being honest. Devoid of religious significance or the idea of love, marriage is nothing but an awful contract that you shouldn't sign. I'm just being real. Because you start out loving each other, and then like 2 years later, you're just building a case against one another for a hypothetical court date that may or may not ever happen.
So about 5 years ago, pretty much everyone who I know started to get married. And that was strange for me, because I don't really believe in the idea of marriage. And that would have been fine, except I have a problem where sometimes when I think that I am right about something, it can be a real source of tension between me and the person I'm arguing with. And the reason it's a source of tension is that I'm right. And so I remember distinctly talking to my friend Dana, and she goes, well, you don't believe in marriage for you, but you, of course you believe in it for other people. And I was like, no, I think it's insane, you know, for anyone. And she said, why? And I said, well, first of all, it just seems doomed. You know, 50% of marriages end in divorce. That's just first marriages, by the way. Second marriages, 60 to 62% end in divorce. Third marriages, 70 to 75% end in divorce. That's a learning curve. Second of all, monogamy is impossible, or at very least, not a sure thing. When I say that, I think people assume that I'm implying that men are incapable of being faithful. But I think women are just as incapable, but for more sophisticated reasons, you know? I mean, with men, we're just really simple, you have a very simple sexuality. When I say that, my female friends are like, well, we like sex just as much as you do. And I say, sure, but it's different. And they say, how? And I say, have you ever masturbated while driving a car?
Okay, so now listen, I'm loving being divorced. I mean, it's been 4 years, but people still get upset. They still worry about me, you know, and it's really just a legal term, meaning no one's farted in my bed in 4 years. It's not a big deal. There have been people in it, but I don't get close enough for them to get to farting level, because that's where it all ends, really. When you say, it's intimacy. No, it's a secret hatred, is what it is someone is gassing you because they secretly hate you. But you bill it as intimacy and all the other things married people say about the awful things that come with making yourself live with a person for no reason other than you want someone to find your corpse someday. I mean, that's really all it is. I do want to say this. I'm not against marriage, but I do think that married people kind of suck. I really do. I know, don't be offended. I know, like, you're good people, like, individually. You're like, I give to Kittens Without Whiskers charity every year. I know. But the way you treat single people, I have been on both sides, so I know. I remember what I did. The way you treat single people is not good. Do we have single people here, right? Do you agree with me? The way you get treated, your married friends invite you over, and they put you on the couch and they stare at you like you're a pillow that doesn't make sense to them. Like, what do we do with that? We have to match that somehow. Or they think that it's fun for you to have dinner with them, just the three of you. And you feel like they're weird 30 to 40 year old kid that never left the house. And they're like, isn't this fun? You're like, no, because I'm not in the marriage. I want to go where the people are outside.
I love my husband. I laugh at his jokes. I think he's fantastic. And then all day, every day, I want to punch him in his dumb face. And it's not the big things that make you want to kill your spouse. It's little stuff. Little stuff. Like, why does he have to ask me where everything is? All the time. In his own goddamn house. Like, I'm Carson the butler, and we live in Downton Abbey or something. All day, on a loop. Where are the keys? Where's the dog? Where's the garage? When we got married, we were so poor, we lived in a studio apartment. A studio apartment. And he had the nerve to ask me where stuff was. Where's the spatula? I'm like, motherfucker. Everything we own. Is out. Like, what? How lazy are you?
When you have a newborn baby, your marriage is very weak because you're both stressed out. You look like shit because you don't shower no more. You're resentful of each other. Whose idea was it to bring this new roommate into the world? Your marriage is very vulnerable and easy for an outsider to invade and colonize. If we had hired a 25-year-old man who was not ugly,
Of
great with my daughter and said yes immediately to every chore I asked him to do with a positive attitude. Oh, you best believe that I would eat the shit out of his butthole. Every day. Every day would be an all-day nanny butthole buffet. I don't care if his 25-year-old butt cheeks got all nervous and clenched up and closed on my face like elevator doors. I would get in there and just... like Jack Nicholson in The Shining. Just...
Who's my? You're married. How long? Not long, right? Two weeks?
2 years.
Oh, 2 years. Okay. But still, that's short. But when you married a long time, see, in the beginning of a relationship, you're in the do no wrong phase, right? Whatever you do, it's cute, it's sweet. And then we've crossed over. I'm in the do no right. I'm in the do no right. You know, I just have to accept it. I have to just know. Here's an example. I'm walking through, she's watching TV, and I'm walking through and I offer. I say, oh, I'll get you some popcorn. I know she likes popcorn. And I offer, I'll get you popcorn. To which she says, all right, but bring enough. She's already pissed off. She's already pissed off at me. She'd rather have no popcorn than not enough popcorn. Yeah. It's unbelievable.
So I'm getting married. One of the lovely things about the man that I'm marrying is that he has never asked me to change anything about myself. This is a very weird job. We're on a ship and I'm telling jokes. Like, those things don't go together. He's always been very respectful of my job. He's never asked that I not go on the road, that I not go to work, that I not take a gig. The only thing he's ever asked that I not do was a couple weeks ago, we were getting ready for bed, and I came out dressed, and he looked at me and he went, babe, love you. Can you not wear men's basketball shorts to bed? And I was like, interesting request, proceed. And he goes, love you, I think you're beautiful. It's just that I'm not as attracted to you, and I don't really want to have sex with you when you're in men's basketball shorts. And I was like, oh, that's the idea. Thanks for the ring, fucker! Yeah! He's sitting in the back, he's like, no, we fuck, I mean. My dad's also here, so that was a weird take. Okay, so.
I got married late in life, I was 45, I had some issues. Was enjoying those issues quite a bit, as I recall. When I was single, I had married friends, I would not visit their homes. I found their lives to be pathetic and depressing. Now that I'm married, I have no single friends. I find their lives to be meaningless and trivial experiences. In both cases, I believe I was correct. Whichever side of marriage you're on, you don't get what the other people are doing. I can't hang out with single guys. If you don't have a wife, we have nothing to talk about. You have a girlfriend? That's wiffle ball, my friend. You're playing paintball war. I'm in Afghanistan with real loaded weapons. Married guys play with full clips and live rounds. This is not a drill. Single guy sitting on a merry-go-round blowing on a pinwheel. I'm driving a truck full of nitro down a dirt road.
I'm married, I'm still married, and I, thanks, yeah.
I like to say it, you know, like I'm at the same job, just like, yeah, no, still work there. Yeah, right out of high school. Only job I applied for. My wife will tell me that she always says that I don't like the way she talks. And it's not her voice. I like the sound of her voice. That'd be a big problem, I think, if it was like, it's your voice. I just hate it. Just to go to couples therapy and be like, can you hear it right? Like, it's not, you know, it's not fun. It's the information that she chooses to tell me at times. We took a trip to Florida, to Fort Lauderdale, and her and our daughter are flying from Nashville, where we live, and I'm flying from Detroit. We're meeting at Fort Lauderdale's airport. I have to find them when they land. So I called her, because I was about to take off, and I was like, all right, what time do you guys leave? She goes, noon. And it was 11:30, and they're still at home. I was like, Laura, I don't know if you even know what an airport is. But if that plane was in our driveway, I don't think you could make it. And she said, that's what time you leave for the airport. Our flight's not till 1:30. And I was like, all right. So what do you think I wanted to know when I asked that? Is that what you thought the best time you could give me was a time that means nothing to nobody? What time did you go to bed last night? Just tell me that, and I'll just look up all the planes that land in Florida, and I'll guess which one I think you're on. She said, I'm sorry I don't talk the way you want me to talk. I'm like, I want you to talk like a regular person, all right? Like you've been around people before, you know? We didn't talk in Florida, I'll tell you that.